If you're a Pro Tools user, I'd be willing to bet that you've probably spent more time than you would like tediously adjusting plugin settings. So in this video, I'm going to show you three different ways that you can copy settings inside of Pro Tools. Hello and welcome to the video. My name is Malcolm Owen-Flood, and today I'm going to show you three different ways that you can copy plugin settings inside of Pro Tools so that you don't have to waste a bunch of time just manually adjusting them, especially if you know that you want the same settings on multiple tracks. It's a total workflow hack, and making music is meant to be fun and not tedious. So this is going to help you with that, but do stay tuned to the end because I have one little bonus tip on plugin presets that I'm going to throw in at the end of this video. All right, our first method is dragging plugin copies. I've got the perfect example session pulled up where I've got a stack of guitars, and normally our stacks of guitars are a left and a right, but in this case, it's actually four of them. And that's kind of a cool thing because in this song, we split the like high portion of the chord that was being played, which is like this. And the low portion, like the bass notes on the guitar, like this. And then join them together, we have four guitar tracks that sound like two. But now let's say we wanted to EQ these guitars and we wanted those settings to be the same on all four tracks. Well, if we load up an EQ, FabFilter Pro Q3, great plugin, my go-to EQ. And let's just say we want to add some bottom end. I'll just solo this one guitar to start. Some low mids. Honestly, that sounds terrible, but let's just pretend that's what we wanted to do. Now, do I have to go and then make another insert on the next guitar and try and copy that over and just make this big boost and then go check, did I get it the same? Oh, I'm a little off. That would be a disaster, not how we want to do it, right? So that's where dragging plugin settings comes in. Super easy. We're just going to hold option and then grab the plugin that we want to copy over and just drag it down onto the next track. Rinse and repeat. Now all four tracks have the same EQ boost. So bam, done. Dragging plugin copies, probably my most used method. Now directly copying the plugin works really well when the tracks are beside each other like that. But what if we wanted to copy that plugin to something really far away in the session, like a vocal down here? That would be a big drag and you might drop in the wrong place. It could go wrong. It's not super smooth, but there is a solution for that. And we call that using the copy settings option inside of Pro Tools. So to show you that, I'm just going to go to that same guitar we had here, and let's say we wanted to take this boost and apply it on a vocal. It's not something you normally want to do, but you might want to do something like take a reverb that you're using on this guitar and apply it to a vocal, something like that, or a distortion. So pretend this is whatever plugin you want, and you're just going to go to this little arrow right here inside of every plugin window. It doesn't matter what plugin you are in. Pro Tools always has this little button beside preset. We'll click that and you will see that there is a copy settings option. We can also save settings, but that's gonna come up later. For now, we're gonna copy settings and you can also do this with a shortcut. It is Shift Command C, as you can see right there. Click that and now let's go down and find our vocal. Now, if the plugin wasn't already open that track, you do have to open the plugin first, but then we can go to that same menu, click that drop-down window and click paste settings. There it is, it's done. And if you wanted to use the shortcut, Shift Command V this time. So Shift Command C to copy, Shift Command V to paste. That can be super handy when the tracks aren't beside each other. So now we've got two options. You can drag the plugin over and just make an exact duplicate of the plugin, or you can actually just copy the settings and paste them right into the plugin. But here's an even better way to do it that I really love. And to do that, we're gonna go to our guitars again. And this is called grouped mirrored plugin settings. All right, so we're gonna go back to those guitars, like I said, and we've got all four of them and we want them all to have the same plugins happening. And whatever settings are on one plugin should be the same on all four of them. That's the goal. So what we do is we select the tracks that we want this to happen to, and we can go Command G. Command G is going to bring up this group window, and you can also find that under track group. You'll see that currently in the group, it already has the tracks that I selected there. You could add more or less, whatever you need to do. I would rename this to be whatever we want. So this is going to be called G1 group for me. That's guitar one. And now here's the important part. You want to unclick follow globals and go to attributes. Inside of attributes, you can do all sorts of stuff. But the most important thing is that we want to make sure controls is checked. And I like to have bypass checked too. But what that controls button is going to do is mean that anything that gets changed on any of these inserts, and these inserts are where our plugins are inserted, they're going to mirror that on all of them. So we're making sure that is checked. And then just for more information, bypass means that if I bypass one, it's gonna bypass the plugin on all of them. And volume, it's gonna share volume across all of them. And if I mute one of them, it's gonna mute all of them. And we could get it to share pan, whatever we want. There's heat options, solos, all of it's available. But this is what we want for right now. Controls checked. Then we can just click OK. Now that is done, we just have to make sure the group is on. So go find your group in your little group window in the bottom left here. I see that G1 is highlighted and we should be off to the races. So I'm gonna yank this down and let's check the next one. Yep, it's down. Let's do a big top boost. Let's check the next one. You can see that it is mirrored. It has done it to all of them. There's a catch to this though. If I put in a new plugin here, let's just go with this new L1 limiter plugin that I really like from Cornif Audio. I think this plugin's free, by the way, so go check out Cornif Audio and scoop this plugin. And now if I adjust this, well, you can see that I did adjust that, but on the other tracks, that plugin doesn't exist. So the plugin has to exist on all of the tracks for this to work. And if you have them out of order, so for example, if I had the EQ on the first track here, not in line with these other EQs, and I make a change, this EQ will not reflect it. So they're tied to their insert level. So in this case, this is insert C, A, B, C, and now they will all respond the same. So if you're wondering how to set that up, you just have to first launch that plugin on all of them. And there is a little speed tip for that. It's an extra bonus tip. It's not actually the bonus tip I'm going to be including. It's an extra bonus tip on top of that bonus tip. You're going to hold Shift Option, and then go insert the plugin like you normally would. So L1 is what we want on all of these. There we go. It just opened on all of them. You can see the settings are different, but they should be mirrored. And that's just because I made that one first and then adjusted it. But I think that will actually snap too if I just adjust this a little bit. Let's go look at the other one. Yep. Now they're all matching whatever the last change was. So super smooth. And I like doing this with pairs of guitars because I always have left and right guitars in general. So for my rhythm guitars anyways. So it's just built into my template that way. And I instantly know that if I'm changing one, it's mirrored on the other side. And you can always turn that off if you want them to be different too. Now I did mention that I had one bonus tip coming for you and let's get to that. This is when you have the same settings that you want on different songs. So you want to copy settings, not just inside of this session, but do other sessions too. And my favorite way of doing that, and there is more than one way to do this, so if this doesn't sound like the solution for you, comment down below, let me know, and I'll make a video on all the different ways I can think of on how to do this. But this is my most common, and that is called plugin presets. So under preset, you're now going to go down to this button that says factory default, and here is where you can have presets. So if I click tilt, I have this preset where it just has a tilt plugin built right in. And the real quick version of how to do this is that you just set it up how you want. Let's say we always wanted a boost like that or a tilt like that. And then you just go click that little arrow again and save settings as, label it whatever you'd like. Tilt works fine. Bam. Oh, I just renamed it 3. I accidentally missed my enter button. Oh well, now I've got a preset called 3 and tilt. Perfect. That will save. That's in my sessions. No matter which session I open up, I can open up another instance of ProQ, and under presets, there's my 3. It's right there. And yeah, you are off to the races. You've got 3 different ways now. You can drag and drop duplicates of plugins. You can copy the settings directly. You can mirror the settings among different tracks, or you can even set your own presets and just import those as you need them as well. I hope this helped. And if you want to go a little bit deeper on getting that preset set up and maybe even making that the default, so when you open the plugin, it has the preset you wanted, I've got another video for that right here already made. So you can check that out and learn it right now. If you enjoyed this, please consider subscribing and I will see you in the next one. Adios.